Hello friends, once again I warm welcome to an online platform for the student of life science Botany4U, all the respected founder members of Botany4U, all the respected teachers, research scholar and students from various colleges and universities of the all over India. Today we are participating the third days of National Workshop on CSIR UGC NET JRF LS Preparation in Life Science Part 6. Today I am going to deliver the lecture on basic concepts of the developmental biology. This is my brief introduction. Myself Shubham Ashok Rao Rathod. I am working as an assistant professor at Department of Botany in Sri Shivaji College of Arts, Commerce and Science, Akola. So let's start today's topic, that is developmental biology. You know that development, it is the long life process, but in this video lecture we are just considering the embryonic stages or the embryonic development. So development, it is the process in which the single cell gives rise to the multicellular organism. Basically the development is start from the fertilization, when male and female nuclei fuse together, they producing the diploid zygote. After the fertilization of the zygote or the formation of the zygote, this zygote undergoes the series of rapid and synchronized manners of cell division that gives rise to the embryo. So we can say that this embryo, it is the earliest form of the development of animal as well as plants. So development, it is the always progressive in nature and it is irreversible in nature. So we can divide or we can describe the development into certain heads, such as: so development involve certain overlapping processes like growth, differentiation and morphogenesis. So in growth, there is growth, it is due to the two reasons. There is a two processes are there, that is the cell division is there and cell expansion is there. So cell division and cell expansion, it's result into the growth of that particular zygote, and mass of the cells or the mass of that particular cells get increased. Okay, so we can say that the growth of that particular zygote taken place. Then this, after the certain round of the cell division, that certain cell undergoes into the differentiation. Differentiation, it means the diversification of the cell. It means the cells attain their own function that they want to proceed. Okay, so after the differentiation, after the diversification of the cell, certain mass of the cells undergoes into the formation of certain pattern formation, that is the organization of that differentiated cell. So due to the organization of the different, certain patterns were developed. Okay, and this pattern formation leads to the morphogenesis, that is the formation of certain shapes and structures, such as consider when the embryonic or the seeds were developed, and you know that in the seeds of the plant there is an embryo is present, and after the imbibition process all the cells of that embryo get activated and they start to rapid cell division, and in this rapid cell division the such kind of pattern formation where it takes place. So there the radical is developed and plumule is developed. So this is the certain kind of the formation of the shapes and structure, so that is called as the morphogenesis. So such kind of pattern formations were occur into the embryonic development also. So that is known as the pattern formation that leads to the morphogenesis, that we have to study in detail in next slides. Okay, so let's consider. So we have to discuss the characteristic features of the growth. You know that in a plant, growth is due to the cell division and cell elongation. As we have seen, the growth having the two phases, that is the cell division followed by cell elongation. Once upon the cell is divided, then cell is get elongate. And so in this plant growth, the cell division and cell elongation are start just after the formation of zygote. Okay, so cell division taken place up to the death in the plant. So that's why we called it as the plant growth is always unlimited or undetermined. Okay, so there is another characteristic features of the plant cell, that is the plant cell having the totipotency. And that means that each and every cell of the plant is totipotent. Totipotent means they can produce the whole plant from the one single cell. Okay, so each and every living cell of that plant, it is a totipotent and it can act as a stem cell. Okay, so you can see here there are the different stages of the developmental stages of the plant. So this is the zygote after the fertilization. After the fertilization, this zygote will form. After this is the 2N. After the certain series of the cell division, there is a two cell structure is formed, and this two cell structure then followed by the four cell structure. And so you can see here there is a two cell structure. So there are two different cells are there in plant. Basically there are the unsynchronized manner of the cell division takes place, that we have to study in following slides. But so you can see here, so this is the basal cell and this is the apical cell. So in this apical cell, you can see that this apical cell were developed into the further development, but this basal cell remain growing very slowly. So you can see, so such type of development were taken place into the plant. Then this 8 cell structure get converted into globular structure, that is the globular embryo were formed. Okay, so there are the different parts of that embryo were developing, and this globular embryo were then converted into heart shaped embryo. And this heart shaped embryo then converted into the torpedo embryo. And after this, the seed formation where takes place into the plant, seed formation. And after the formation of seed, once this seed is undergoes into the germination, after the process of imbibition, that proceed into the vegetative development. So these are the embryonic stages of the plants that we have discussed in these slides. So let's see the developmental growths of the animal cells. How the animal cells were grow? Okay, so growth of the animal cell or the animal zygote or the overall animal individual, it is up to the certain time of interval. So we can say that, so growth of the animal, it is the determined up to specific time limit. So we can say that the growth, it is up to certain type of interval. So this is the determined type of the growth which is found in the animal. But in early growth, it is occur only due to the cell division. So early cell division, early growth of the zygote of animal, which is only due to the cell division, not due to the cell expansion. It means that this the early this zygote where undergoes into the series of cell division without following of the cell expansion. It means that in which the cell division does not followed by the cell expansion. Okay, and such type of cell division is known as, that is the cleavage. This process is known as the cleavage. In animal embryo undergoes into the cleavage, it is the rapid division. It is the rapid division of the cells in early embryo without any growth. Without any growth. So we have to also discuss about the characteristic features of the process, that is cleavage. Okay, so we have to discuss here the characteristic features of the cleavage. So as we have discussed, in early development of the embryo of animal, this zygote undergoes into the certain series of the cell division without cell expansion. So due to this, the size of the cell get decreases. The size of the cell get decreases from zygote to blastula. Okay, so this is the zygote, this is the 8-cell structure, and this is the blastula. Okay, so from zygote to blastula, there is an absence of cell expansion. There is a cell expansion is absent. So due to this absence of cell expansion, after each round of cell division, the size of that particular cell get decreases rapidly. So during earlier, in this earlier division, there is no cell expansion. As we know, the cell were expand into the G1 and G2 phase. Okay, but in this earlier growth or the earlier cell division, there is an absence of G1 and G2 phase. G1 and G2 phase. As we know, the cell division having the four different phases, such as the G1 phase, followed by S phase, followed by G2 phase and M phase. And again, two daughter cell were formed, and this daughter cell undergoes into the G1 phase, S phase, and such type of cell division, cell cycle get continuously. But in earlier cell division, there is an absence of G1 and G2 phase. In absence of G1 and G2 phase, due to this, the earlier cell division does not having the cell expansion process. And due to the absence of this G1 and G2 phase, this cell division, this earlier cell division are taken place very rapidly, because in general the cell division takes 14-24 hours, but during this cleavage or the earlier development, the cleavage of the zygote cell division completes within the 30 minutes. Each round of the cell division of the early cell division of the zygote takes the 30 minutes only. So because there is an absence of G1 and G2 phase, because these two phases takes more time to grow up, and for these two phases, the interval of time is required. But due to the absence of this G1 and G2 phase into the earlier cell division, so this cell division taken place within the 30 minutes only. So what is the result of this early cell division? So you can see that, so this is the zygote, this is the larger zygote cell, and after the certain division, the mass of the cell that is constant, but number of the cell division and number of cell get increases, number of cell increases, number of the cell increases, But size of cell were decreases. So you can see, as compared to this zygote cell, these all the cells were are very small in size. Okay, so after this zygote to the blastula, after each round of cell division, the number of the cell increases, but size of the cell is always decreases. So, and envelope remain constant. So you can see that the total envelope of this overall, it is remain constant as similar to the zygote, but number of cell increases and cell size get decreases. Along with this cell division, when we go from zygote to blastula, the amount of cytoplasm where decreases. And number of nucleus also increases. So the ratio of the nucleus, upon volume of cytoplasm, equals to, suppose consider there is the 10 cells having the 10 nucleus, and this is the volume, of cytoplasm. So answer comes, that is the 1. But after the cell division, second round of the cell division, this number of nucleus get double, that is 20, and this cytoplasm, volume of cytoplasm get half. So answer comes 4. The ratio of this nucleus upon cytoplasm where increases. Okay, again, after the third round of the cell division, this number of nucleus again get doubled, and cytoplasmic cytoplasm volume also get decreased. So you can see each round of the cell division, you can say that the nucleus upon cytoplasm ratio is always increases. So this ratio is always increases. So from 1 to 4, 4 to, so ratio of nucleus and cytoplasm where increases. So it is the characteristic features of the cleavage. So let's discuss about the next slides. Then this is the another characteristic features that we have discussed little bit in a previous lecture, that is, growth may be determined and undetermined in animal. So you can say in earlier stages or the earlier very in young ages, there is a abundant amount of the stem cells were there, or the embryonic stages having the stem cells, then this stem cell were performing the different and differentiated into the different type of the cells, such as this stem cell can differentiated into the mast cell, then certain stem cell were developed into the blood cell, that is the RBC, and certain stem cells were developing the neuron, certain stem cell were developing as a liver cell, and certain act as a intestinal cell. So stem cell have the capacity to differentiate into each and every kind of the cell. In animal cell, after certain stages of the life, the growth is stopped. So for the continuous growth, the stem cells are responsible. But in animal, as the age of that organism increases, the stem cells were restricted to the some specific parts of the body, such as the stem cells for the RBC formation, that is the process known as the hematopoiesis, and were the present in the bone marrow of that particular organism. So in bone marrow, the stem cells for the RBC formations are always present up to the end of the life. Also, in the germ cell or the reproductive organ of that particular organism, the germ cells, this having the germ cells, that is also one kind of the stem cells, and these cells takes part into the spermatogenesis and the oogenesis. Okay, so these germ cells also one kind of the cell, but another parts of the these stem cells were restricted. Okay, so that's why due to this reason the growth of the animal, it is the determined. This is the determined or the specific up to the certain time of interval. But where in animal where the stem cells present, the number of the stem cells in the body is always maintained over the life. So you can say that how is this possible? So what's happened after the each cell division? So suppose consider this is the stem cell, and after the cell division of this stem cell, the two stem cells were developed. Okay, so two daughter stem cells were developed, and out of these two daughter cell, one remain maintain, or this out of these two stem cell, one does not take part into the further differentiation, but another will take part into the further differentiation process. So due to this such a mechanism, the stem cell, number of the stem cell always remain constant all over the life. Okay, but growth of the plant, it is the undetermined. In plant, the growth is undeterminate because of the plant having the meristematic cells. And these meristematic cells were present at the root. Apical meristems are there, root apical meristems, then shoot apical meristem, then intercalary meristem is there, then lateral meristem is there. So due to the presence of this meristem, because these meristems are always in dividing condition, so these meristematic cells are continuously divides, and that leads to the unlimited growth of the plant. And each and every cell of the plant is totipotent, as we have discussed in previous slides, and each and every cell can act as a stem cell. But specially these meristematic cells, where it is the undifferentiated cells, and these undifferentiated cells were developed into the undergoes into the undeterminate growth of the that plant. So due to the presence of this meristematic cell, the plant growth is always undeterminate or unlimited. So this is the another characteristic features of the growth. So growth may be isometric or allometric. Isometric growth means synchronized manner of the cell division. In this synchronized manner of the cell division, the cells were divided equally. After each division of the cell, the number of the cell become double. So you can see here, it is occur in specially in the animals. Animal embryonic growths are taken place through this isometric growth. So in this isometric growth, the single zygotic cell were developed into the equal sized two cell structure, and this two cell structure were again developed into the four cell structure, and this four cell structure were developed into the eight cell structure or the eight cell stage, and this eight cell stage undergoes into the 16 cell stage, and followed by the morula, that is the again 32 or the cell structure of morula, and morula is followed by the blastula. So up to this blastula there is a isometric growth were found, but after the blastula, where as we have discussed in previous slides, the cell expansion gets start. The cell expansion gets start. So before this, after this blastula level, then this blastula undergoes into the gastula, and gastula develops into the larva, and larva gives the adult individual. So these are the, but in these earlier stages of this embryonic growth, the isometric growth were found in the animals. Then second one, it is the allometric growth. Allometric growth means unsynchronized manner of cell division. In this type, the cells were divide unequally, and some cell will grow rapidly and some cells will develop gradually or slowly. As we know, in such type of cell division or the growth is found in the plant cell or the plant embryonic stages. So you can see this is the zygotic cell. This zygotic cell, after the first round of the cell division, that gives rise to the two types of the cell. So you can see that there is a apical cell and basal cell. This basal cell grow very slowly, while this rapid growth were found in the apical region, and this apical region further develop into the embryo. So in this allometric growth, certain, because this is the one most reason, that is the, there is a presence of cell wall in the plant cell, and due to the presence of cell wall, there is a need to organized manner of the cell division where it takes place. So to attain the special structure, so such unsynchronized manner of the cell division where proceed into the plant embryonic stages. So growth. So as we have discussed in the development, growth always followed by the differentiation. As we have seen in the first slide, so in this plus side, we have differentiated or divided the development, overall development, into the three phases. That is the growth followed by the differentiation, and differentiation followed by the morphogenesis. So this development, in the development, the growth always followed by the differentiation. It is the process in which the cell attained the specific size, specific shape and functions, and that process is known as, that is the differentiation process. So in this differentiation, so question should come in your mind, how the cell decide to perform specific function, okay, and how the cell were differentiated. So answer is that in between the growth and differentiation phase, the cell undergoes into the commitment. There is a one process in between the growth and differentiation, and that process is known as the commitment process, in which the certain cells commit to their functions that they want to perform in future. Okay, so this commitment is depend on the expression of genes. This, as we know, the cytoplasm of the each zygote having the so many different kinds of the cytoplasmic determinants, cytoplasmic transcription factors are there, and after the blastula stage or the egg cell structure, where the embryonic genes start to express. So expression of the genes leads to the commitment. So at the 4 to 8 cell stage, the commitment process where start. Okay, so it is due to the expression of the genes, then environmental conditions are also affecting to the expression of certain gene or the commitment of that particular cells. Okay, and also the presence of cytoplasmic determinants that we have to discuss in previous lecture. So cytoplasmic determinants are combinedly forms together by means of the mRNA proteins transcription factors, which are already present in the zygotic cell. But as the cell divisions takes place, these cytoplasmic determinants were distributed into the each and every cells. Okay, so during the growth, the cell division and cell expansion play an important role. Along with the cell division, dividing cell decide what they want to become, and that process is known as that is the commitment. But actually the commitment, it is the result of two stages. Okay, so this commitment having the two stages, that is the specification and determination. So specification, it is known as the early commitment. Early commitment, and this is the late commitment. So this commitment, it is the result of the two stages, that is the specification and determination. So let's consider the specification. So specification, it is mainly is of the three types, such as the autonomous specification, then conditional specification, then syncytial specification. So this all the kinds of the specification, it is due to the certain stimulation. For this all the specification or the early commitment, certain stimulation of the external factor is required. This stimulation may comes from the outer environment or from the cell to cell communication. So you can see that this is the signal, this is the signaling molecule, and this is the signal receptor is there, signal receptor, and this is the single cell of the 8-cell stage that having the signal receptor. And once this signal is reaches and bind together with this signal receptor, certain cellular cytoplasmic cascades were generated. This is the certain series of the reaction that activates the transcription factors. So as the result of this cellular cytoplasmic cascade, certain transcription factor were get activated, or they become activated, and it get undergoes into the nucleus and bind on the DNA. So this and proceed the transcription process. And in this transcription, the specific amount of the gene were synthesized. So because each and every genes were expressed on the basis of the transcription factor which are available at that time. Okay, so transcription factor determines which gene have to express. So after this action of this transcription factor, this mRNA were formed, and this mRNA were undergoes into the protein. So these specifications may reversible in nature. So in this specification, cell decide to carry the certain function, but it is possible that specification may reversible. Okay, may get reverse. ओके, बट दिस स्टेज अप टू दिस ट्रांसक्रिप्शन लेवल दिस रिवर्सिबिलिटी ऑफ द रिवर्स मैकेनिज्म ऑफ द स्पेसिफिकेशन इज प्रेजेंट, बट वंस द प्रोटीन इज एक्सप्रेस इन द फॉर्म ऑफ प्रोटीन देन दैट स्पेसिफिकेशन कांट रिवर्स बैक. सो वी हैव टू स्टडी दिस ऑल द थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ द स्पेसिफिकेशन. सो स्पेसिफिकेशन, सो सच फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द ऑटोनॉमस स्पेसिफिकेशन. इन ऑटोनॉमस स्पेसिफिकेशन विच इज फाउंड इन द मोलुस्का मेंबर्स ऑफ मोलुस्का देन ट्यूनिकेट्स एंड एनालिट्स. सो यू कैन रिमेंबर इट इज एज ए एम टी ए और द ए टी एम. ओके, वॉट एवर मे बी यू कैन मेमोराइज दिस मोलुस्का ट्यूनिकेट्स एंड एनालिट्स. ओके, सो दिस इज द ऑटोनॉमस स्पेसिफिकेशन. It is the early determined specification. So this is the irreversible specification. It means when this autonomous specification is taken place into the certain cells of that embryonic stages, then this autonomous specification is always irreversible. So it is the commitment at a one time. It is the commitment at a one time. And follow that commitment up to the differentiation. It means that for example, during embryo formation, certain cells are determined about their function and type. That cell shows the specification. Okay, so during this early determined autonomous specification, in the autonomous specification, the commitment occurs at 4 to 8 cell stage. 4 to 8 cell stage. 8 cell stage. And this embryonic gene expression were started from the mid blastula stages, and final determination, actual achieving the differentiation, that is the final determination of the that function, it is occur at the mid gastrula. But this, once this autonomous specification is taken place, it means that that cell will proceed into the and achieve only that functions. Okay, so you can say that these are the different stages. So this is the first cell structure. Then this is the two cell structure. This is the four stage structure, four cell structure, followed by eight cell structure or the stage. It is followed by that is the 16 cell stage. And this 16 cell undergoes into the 32 celled structure. And then this cell structure is formed the morula, and then this morula get developed into the blastula. So what's happened in this autonomous cell division, this autonomous specification were started from this 4 to 8 cell structure. So we have to see one example. Suppose there is a one blastula level and there is a certain cells. You can see this is the very fine photographs of the blastula stage, and you can see the different stages. So which the cells which are present in these regions of the blastula, they have undergoes into the autonomous specification at their four cell structure. Okay, so suppose this is the cell which are these two cells were required for the formation of eye. Okay, and these cells is autonomous speciated, or these cells have undergoes into the autonomous specification. So these cells already have decided that they want to become a eye cell, or they want to form the eye of that particular organism. Suppose experimentally, if we remove that cell, that is autonomous speciated cell, if we remove that cell from this region and put it into another region, then as a result of that, they will synthesize the eye at the region of this mesodermal layer. So this is the mesodermal layer. So specifically, the location of this eye cell, there is a present in this region. But we have removed that cell from this region and put it into this mesophyllous cell, then these cells were developing the eye into this mesophyllous cell, because these cells have already decided in the earlier stage, because this cell have to, so there is no effect of the corresponding mesodermal type of the conditions, or the mesodermal atmosphere, there is no effect of this atmosphere of the mesodermal cells on this autonomously speciated cell. Okay, so you can say that, so this cell will form the eye into this mesophyllous cell. Okay, and once we remove this early cell, then another cell can't fill up the position of this cell, because this cells is already decided, and another cell can't take the position of that cell. So in this, certain mosaic pattern were developed. Mosaic abnormal development occurred. If in this case, when we remove that speciated cell from this region, is in that case only the mosaic development is formed. So conditional specification. So you can imagine that, or on the basis of this conditional specification, occurs in the vertebrates, and surrounding conditions determine what that cell would become. Okay, so surrounding conditions determine the function or the determination of that cell. So in the conditional specification, the signaling molecules are called as inducer, which comes from outside or from the adjacent cell, and that play role in the specification process. So in this, prospective potency is higher than the prospective fail. So prospective potency means what that cell can become, and actually that prospective fate means what that cell have to become. So prospective potency is always high than the prospective fate. In such specification, the late determination takes place. So conditional specification occurs at early blastula. So this conditional specification, as we have seen in the autonomous specification, that is takes place at the 4 to 8 cell stage. But this conditional specification were taken place into the early blastula stage. In early blastula set, and in mid blastula, the embryonic genes start to express. Okay, because once the cell decided, then this cell proceed into the expression of the particular gene to achieve the specific function. And in once the embryonic genes were expressed, then determination occur at the mid-gastrula level. For one experiment, so when the actual this conditional specification is occur, so it is the one gastrula stages of the embryo, and in this okay, so this is the reason, and these are the skin cell, and these cells have speciated or the decided to become a skin cell. But if we remove that cell, from here and put it into this mesodermal layer or the mesodermal region of this blastula, then it get convert or it get convert into the mesodermal cell, or it can act as a mesodermal cell at if we remove the this skin cell from the early gastrula stage. Okay, but if we take the skin cell, this skin cell from the mid gastrula and put it into the mesodermal layer, then in this mesodermal layer, now this cell will perform or will perform the skin cell or develop the skin and act as a skin cell. But in the early gastrula, if we remove this skin cell from this region and put it into the blastula of another embryonic stages, then this skin cell will act as a mesodermal cells, because the outermost conditions it is inducing. So such type of specification it is known as it is the conditional specification. So up to the early gastrula, this conditional specification can reversible in nature, but once that gastrula were developed to the mid gastrula, so then this conditional specification can't reverse back. So last one, it is the syncytial specification. It is the observed in the insects in the Drosophila. The early division, it is somewhat different. That is, mitosis where takes place without cytokinesis, means mitosis does not followed by the cytokinesis. As the result of this, the cytoplasm having the many nucleus, because there is no cytokinesis is there. So due to the absence of cytokinesis, the number of nucleus were increases. So, and this phenomenon is known as that is a syncytial specification. So fate of the embryo, it is determined by the environmental condition, cytoplasmic determinant and morphogenes gradient. So you can see in this diagram, so this is the egg cell of the Drosophila, and after the certain round of the cell division where the mitosis where takes place, but mitosis does not followed by the cytokinesis, so that's why only number of nucleus where increases. So number of nucleus were increases, so you can see more than the 100 nucleus were developed, and after this nucleus organized into the internal periphery of the plasma membrane. And once this nucleus organized at the internal periphery of the plasma membrane, then this plasma membrane start to internalize, or the invagination of this plasma membrane is start, and due to the result of this invagination, there is one cellular or the one cell like structure were developed. So you can see, so such invagination of the plasma membrane result into this formation of such type of partial cells. And in these partial cells, so you can see out of this partial cell there is a cytoplasm, and this cytoplasm having the morphogens, and this morphogens or transcription factor can stimulate or stimulate the specific gene expression. So you can see this is called as the synthesis specification, and you can see there is a different kinds of the morphogenes are present here, and that leads to the formation of heads, thoracic region, and tail region. So this is the atmospheric condition and the morphogenes and the cytoplasmic determinants were deciding the what type of the differentiation they cell want to develop in this particular stages of the embryo. So you can say that this is the synthesial specification. Then determination. So after the growth, there is a growth is followed by the determination, but in between the growth and determination there are the two phases, that is the specification and the determination. So in determination, some time determination takes place at the 4 to 8 cell structure in case of autonomous specification. In some organism, determination takes place at the blastula level, and most of the determination occurs at the mid blastula. So these are the different stages. So 4 to 8 cell structure in which the commitment, that is the specification, is start, and commitment in some organism the commitment or the specification or the determination takes place at the 4 to 8 cell structure, and into the some early blastula determination where takes place. But specifically in early blastula there is a specification where perform, and in early glastula there the determination where takes place. So you can imagine on the basis of that. Then morphogenesis, it is the last type of the development or the last phase of the development, that is the morphogenesis. So morphogenesis means the formation of shapes and structure. So morpho means form and genesis means creation. So this morphogenesis having the three phases, that is the pattern formation, that is the organization of the differentiated cell, then morphogenes and apoptosis. So what is meant by the pattern formation? So pattern formation is that in the plant development the cell wall is present and cell can't migrate from one location to another into the embryo. So organized cell division and organized cell expansion is more important. So as the result of this organized cell division and organized pre-decided cell expansion, the basal and apical cell were differentiated, and apical cell were grow very rapidly as compared to the basal cell. But in animal cell, the cell movement is very important, and each and every cell can migrate from one place to another into that particular embryo. And this movement of the cell very important for the morphogenesis. Then second point, that is the morphogens are also important for the morphogenesis. So what is this morphogens? So morphogens are very important. The morphogens are morphogenesis, it is the result of the regulatory activity of the genes and their product, and that is nothing but these called as the morphogens. Okay, so these morphogens play an important role. So regulated activity of the gene, and that gene called as the morphogen. So then final point, that is the apoptosis or the program cell death. So you can see here the morphogenesis of the formation of shape and structure, the apoptosis and program cell death play an important role. Then how this apoptosis and program cell death perform their important role in the morphogenesis? So you can see here there is a early development leaf. So we are considering this vegetative example to understand this apoptosis. Okay, so once this vegetative leaf part where undergoes into the program cell death and form the certain pattern or certain structure of the leaf, special structure of the leaf. So you can see the cells which are present in this region, redly red colored paint japper. So this shaded region in which the cell undergoes into the process of apoptosis, and after the apoptosis the such type of wedges or such type of clefts were formed, or such type of design or such type of pattern formation or shape and structure formation were proceed. So in similar, in embryonic stages the unwanted cell were undergoes into the apoptosis to develop into the certain shapes and structure formation. So these are the following processes or the basic concepts of the developmental biology. So we will continue this unit in upcoming lectures. So once again, thank you.